Each airport in the national airspace system has unique and distinct characteristics, which can sometimes lead pilots to use the wrong surface in taxi, takeoff, or landing operations. Let's take a look at some of these tricky areas from the flight deck. North Las Vegas is a medium-sized, primarily general business and corporate aviation airport. It is located in the city of North Las Vegas, just northwest of the Las Vegas Strip. The larger Harry Reid International Airport is located 8 miles south and Nellis Air Force Base 7 miles east. North Las Vegas has its own Class Delta airspace that underlies the larger Las Vegas Class Bravo. Pilots should make themselves familiar with the airspace and their requirements prior to arriving or departing the field. Being familiar with VFR reporting points found on the sectional chart is helpful for air traffic control. North Las Vegas Tower commonly uses the Santa Fe Station Hotel and Casino, located on North Rancho Drive, for the sequencing of aircraft.
2550 North Las Vegas Tower, proceed to Santa Fe for straight in 128.
If you are unfamiliar with this location, let the tower know, and they will provide alternate instructions. The runway configuration consists of two parallel runways with staggered thresholds, runway 12 left and right, and 30 left and right. Runway 725 intersects runway 12 right, 30 left only. The taxiway system provides access to all businesses, facilities, and hangars located on the west side of the airport. As with many airports in this configuration, wrong surface landings and departures are a risk and have occurred. It is imperative that you read back your exact landing clearance and runway assignment to prevent these types of mistakes. Be sure to actively listen to the control instructions issued to you and ask questions if you do not understand. The airport itself can be very difficult to see due to the fact that it blends into the desert environment. In addition, once closer to the airport, the runway surfaces themselves can also be difficult to decipher against the background color of the airport property. As always, advise the tower if you do not have your assigned runway in sight. If IFR rated and assigned to land on either runway 12 left or 12 right, it is recommended that pilots load the ILS or GPS approaches to the runway in which they have been cleared to land on. Alternatively, pilots can establish a GPS waypoint to the approach end of the runway they have been cleared to land on. Pilots should refer to their aircraft or equipment user guide for steps on how to accomplish this. An awareness and understanding of airspace boundaries and their requirements while operating at North Las Vegas is essential to any safe operation. Of particular concern, the Las Vegas Class Bravo airspace is less than 1.5 miles from the approach end of runway 30 right at VGT. When cleared to land on runway 30 left, pilots should be aware that the more dominant and protruding runway 30 right can be mistaken for runway 30 left. The risk of this confusion is greatly increased when pilots execute a tight turn to final from the downwind leg, as they will often see the more dominant protruding runway first. While in the pattern and preparing for the approach, if you need to fly a route other than what was issued to you in order to slow down or descend, you must let the controller know what you are planning to do before you do it. Due to the proximity of the Class Bravo airspace, there are very few options available. For this reason, the risk of overshooting the turn to final is significant, and ATC must be made aware of any potential overshoot. Remember, if you need something, let air traffic control know. It is always good practice to fly standard traffic pattern legs and to avoid continuous 180-degree turns from downwind to final. If traffic for the parallel runway is issued to you and this traffic is not in sight, notify air traffic control immediately. Hotspot 1 concerns pilots instructed runway 7, taxi via Golf. Even after reading back the correct ATC instruction, some pilots still cross the runway 7 hold short lines. You must have a specific clearance to cross any runway, active or not. Hotspot 2 is essentially the same issue as Hotspot 1, but in another location. Once across runway 7, on the way to runway 12 right, aircraft have crossed the hold short lines for runway 12 right. Enhanced taxiway markings, above ground signage, and wigwag lights installed at some locations are only useful if the pilot is looking outside the cockpit while taxiing. Maintain your awareness at all times. Hotspot 3 calls to attention a common hazard that is encountered at many airports where two parallel taxiways for the intersecting runways meet. At North Las Vegas, if a pilot misses the turn from taxiway Alpha onto taxiway Bravo, they are very likely to encroach upon runway 12 right, 30 left. The addition of enhanced markings and signage have virtually eliminated issues at this location, but it is important for pilots to realize that ultimately their awareness is key in avoiding these sorts of potentially dangerous situations. Hotspot 4 is located at the approach end of runway 12 left. The runway hold short lines are set back further than pilots may expect. This is to protect the runway 12 left approach surface. Aircraft taxiing east on taxiway Alpha have taxied across the hold short lines without authorization or have misidentified the surface entirely and actually departed from the taxiway. A contributing factor to this may be that the runway markings for runway 12 left are not visible while on taxiway Alpha due to the inline taxiway. The use of the airport diagram or other map display prior to taxi will help pilots understand their clearances and position on the field, and it will go a long way in reducing this type of error. Other areas of concern at North Las Vegas Airport include aircraft landing runway 12 right and clearing to the south via taxiways Charlie, Hotel, Juliet, or Kilo will end up on taxiway Bravo. This is to clear the runway safety area. The tower is aware of this, expects you to be there, and plans accordingly. Once you are given taxi instructions, please let the tower or ground control know if you are unable to continue immediate forward progress. Listen carefully for instructions after landing. The tower will sometimes give pilots taxi instructions prior to issuing the change to ground control frequency. Once you have arrived or are ready to depart North Las Vegas, be aware that the entire ramp is a non-movement area and as such does not require a clearance from the tower to maneuver within it. The yellow, single solid, and dashed boundary lines let pilots know where the taxiways end and the ramp area begins. After taxiing out to your departure runway, do not contact the tower until you are number one, holding short. This will help minimize frequency congestion. Also, be aware there may be two tower frequencies in use at North Las Vegas. Listen carefully and be sure to be on the correct frequency. Being aware of the hotspots and other configuration issues at North Las Vegas will help pilots make better decisions and, along with the ATC tower, keep the operation safe and efficient. We hope this short video helps you prepare for your trip to the North Las Vegas Airport. It's always better to know before you go.